making news this morning. Reports of a crime spike in northern New South Wales. An offender evading authorities and going on a late night shopping spree at a bottle O. This CCTV has been released of the incident.
Yeah, that's right. A very cheeky echidna has been caught getting loose on the juice. Shop manager Brian Watson-Bell joins us now from the scene of the crime at BWS in Kyogle. Brian, this little guy had a fair bit of fun in your store. How much damage was there when you arrived the next morning?
Well, he did quite a lot of damage. When I opened the door and walked in, I could just see cartons on the floor, cartons of beer open, side stacks moved. Wow. And the further I got in the shop, the more trail of destruction I saw. There was bottles broken, and as you saw from the footage, there was vodka all over the floor and Baileys all over the floor, and he'd made a right mess.
Well, yeah, at least he picked good stuff, you know.
Despite that mess, the offender didn't do a runner. He probably should have. How did you end up tracking him down?
Well, he actually set off our motion sensors in the store. So our security team were alerted, and they actually sent a car out to assess the situation. They had no idea from outside what was happening on the inside of the store, the party he was having. So the following day when I arrived, we were able to track him down, and we knew they looked at their security footage in the store, and they could see the critter inside. And when I got to the store the next day, I tracked him down, and he was curled up underneath the champagne shelf. With a little bottle of champagne beside him, all sleeping it all off, sleeping his hangover off.
Yeah, what was his poison of choice? Champers?
Well, he mixed his drinks a little bit, which he shouldn't do. I mean, we pride ourselves on responsible service of alcohol here, but he mixed his drinks a bit, and I wouldn't be surprised if his drink might have been spiked a little bit too. But...
Oh. Hey, do you know how he actually managed to get inside the store?
He must have got in when we were trading. We were drive-through bottle O, so he must have got in while we were trading.
Oh, yeah.
And apparently it's mating season at the moment, so they're all on the move. And he might have been coming in to try to get some Dutch courage, and he got in that way and found a place to hide overnight, and then we found him the next day.
Now, you could have charged him with drunk and disorderly behaviour, but you let him off with a warning. Where is he now?
Exactly. We should have. Exactly. But when we found him the next day, we were able to get him out. We had the wonderful people from Wires come down to the store, and the lovely Beck was able to remove Bully. We called him Bully because he was a bit of a bulldozer by the shop. And she knew how to get rid of him. And here's a little tip for you, Richard. If ever you get a kid there in your garden, you tickle their belly. Tickle their belly, and then that makes them all relaxed and then you can pick them up. So she was able to do that, wrap them up in towels and pick them up and move him on. And so we here at BWS, we love local, we love our local wildlife. And we really want to say thank you to Wires and the wonderful work they do.
Yeah. They do.
And so we've made a donation of $1,000 from the team here at BWS Kyogle to the local Wires.
How good are you guys?
I know my... local BWS is doing gangbuster business as they are right across Sydney and Melbourne. How are you going? You look pretty well stocked there, mate.
Oh, it's been a crazy year. Absolutely crazy. We've been busier than ever. Yeah. And it's good to have a feel-good story in this crazy world at the moment too, isn't it?
It is. Thanks for coming on our show. The story, we should point out, first appeared in the Richmond River Independent. Thanks to the team there and the echidna, of course, for giving us a good yarn just when we needed one, as Brian said.
Wasn't he gorgeous?